Dear participants, welcome back to the another class on the of the fifth semester of the Advanced Food and Beverage Operation 1. My name is Amit Gupta. I am assistant professor with the Chitkara School of Hospitality. Today what I am going to talk about would be the preliminary restaurant planning and process. Now when you talk about preliminary, it means the steps that we have to take or the concept that we have to take keep in mind that what we are supposed to do to the restaurant, whether it could be existing restaurant or a new restaurant or expansion of the restaurant dining area or the expansion of the kitchen area. So there are different forms, different format that we have to look after. So that is what I'm going to discuss with you today. Let's move forward. What we are going to talk about would be introduction to the preliminary planning. We'll talk about preliminary information form. So these are the two aspects that we are going to cover. We are going to work on the elaborate manner. Okay. Now, what is the preliminary information, planning information? It is used for guiding the overall design of the project, but it does not give all the final answers to all the problem of design. This is the initial stage of planning, because whatever you plan, it might not be concrete, might be concrete also, but keeping in mind, once you do the layout on a blueprint by the architect or by the consultant or by yourself, you'll find what modification need to be done in that. The second thing it talks about general enough, allows for some flexibility in planning. We all know we need to be flexible in planning of a layout, so we need to be flexible in planning. Third thing talks about specific on the other hand on any aspect that are inflexible, such as a few other things that is there, that is the site, the budget, or the size of the building, which is fixed in nature. So keeping in mind what our budget is, what is the location, and what is the size of the building, so keeping those aspects, that will remain the fixed. Now, subject to change after further study and research are completed on the proposed project. So we have to keep in mind what two things we need to change or which could be changed with the development of the project. The project represents a comprehensive summary of the major objective and requirement desirable for the project. So here we need to discuss the summary, or comprehensive summary, what the outlet would be, how the, what it will cover, and many more aspects that is going to look after. Now let's move forward. The form looks like this. So first thing it will talk about is type of project. The project could be a new facility, it could be remodeling of the existing facility, it could be expense of the project, it could be only interior decoration of the particular restaurant or site, it could be only production area of the, or we can say the kitchen area, that need to be, that could be the project, or it could be other things like the porch, the decor of the restaurant, the concept or changing of the equipments or furniture, that could be also part of a project. Second point talks about type of food service facility to be planned. Now, what kind of food service facility that you need to plan? It could be for university or college, it could be a coffee shop, it could be a snack bar, it could be a catering, it could be a union building, it could be university club, it could be a residence club. So these are few of the things that we have to keep in mind. The aspect where it will be located, how it will be located, and what kind of service need to be provided or facilitated in this kind of business. The third aspect talks about commercial restaurants. Commercial restaurant talks about what type of table service would be provided, whether it would be a sit down, whether it would be formal, it could be informal, whether it could be for a cafeteria, whether it could be a coffee shop, whether it would be a drive-in, whether it would be takeout, whether it's a banquet, vending machine, or others. So these are few of the commercial restaurants concept that we have to keep in mind. The next thing that comes into mind is whether, now here, so far we have discussed about the catering to a particular restaurant businesses or catering. Now here it talks about in terms of hospital and nursing. So in case it is in a hospital or in a nursing homes, so we have to look at the aspects whether the service is related to the patient service, patient service, or it is a snack bar. which is for the people or the attendant or the hospital staff or the nursing staff. The aspects talks about hotels, motels, motoring and clubs. We all know what is a hotel, we all know what is a motel and what is motor and clubs. So here we are talking about the expansion of a dining area, that is a preliminary information, whether it would be for a dining area, whether it would be for a room service, or it could be any other catering that you are providing in any of these four aspects. The next in point talks about employee food service. Now employee food service talks about whether we'll have cafeteria for the employees for their different meal periods, whether there would be a vending machine for vending of fountain Pepsi or a Coke or a vending of a tea coffee, an executive dining room for a separate executive people for the manager level and beyond, and other facilities could be in terms of service of tea or a coffee only, or providing snacks in the evening. So we have to keep in mind what food service facility we need to provide to the staff members. Location and market characteristics. Now here we talk about who all would be your clientele, what type of clientele are we going to deal with, what would be their medium income, upper income, lower income, whether it would be for a rural area or for urban area, or it would be for suburban. Now next point, it talks about size of facility and hour of operation, number of seats or cover to be laid out in a particular restaurant, how much cover we need to expand, total number of people to be fed at a particular time, for instance for breakfast, for noon, evening, others talks about dinner and so on. So we need to keep in mind how many number of people we need to entertain in a particular period of time at a particular meal period, that is breakfast, lunch or dinner or supper or evening snacks time, and how many people would be coming to your particular restaurant. The next in line talks about menu characteristics. It talks about what extent of menu that it is, whether it would be a limited menu, whether it would be extensive menu, and do we have alcoholic beverage as part of the menu. We also talk about quality and pricing. The quality and pricing, when we talk about it, could be of three types: high, medium or low. Now in that particular outlet or establishment, what type of service would be provided, whether we will provide table service to the guests, whether there would be a booth service. Suppose it is in a college or university, there might be a booth service to the particular students. We might have a counter service in the restaurant, in the school or university or a college. Whether the catering that you are planning is a self-service outlet or is it a takeout service, car service, or any other mode of service. So keeping in mind these aspects, we have to prepare our menu. Now what kind of standard service? Now standard service talks about speed of the service. In a coffee shop, for instance, if I talk about the food might be in a buffet or it could be through a la carte, where once the guest order for a food, it might be available to the guest in 5 minutes or 10 minutes. Whereas in a fine dining restaurant, it might be only a la carte menu where guests need to order the food and it will take around 15-20 minutes for the guest for the food to be prepared. Course by course, so it takes more time. Now whether we are using a linen in the restaurant or not, what type of linen are we using, what quality of linen, what fabric is the linen, but what pattern of the linen would be there. Now whether we are using a paper or we are using a linen for the placemat, for the coasters, for the dinner napkins and other factors. Now what kind of atmosphere do you want to create in your restaurant? Is it intimate, subdued, formal, informal, cheerful, or any other forms? And what is your future plan for your restaurant business? Whether you want to expand your business, how much you want to expand, keeping in mind those aspects, you have to keep that space with yourself so that future expansion could be kept in mind. Now when we talk about expansion of the capability of a restaurant, it could be in two aspects. It could be a dining area. Suppose you have a 100 cover restaurant and you feel that after 6 months of the business you want to extend or expand your dining areas to 100 to 150 covers. So that much expansion capability and expansion area should be there with you. Second one talks about the kitchen area expansion. As you are going to, as the business is growing and you have more business in your restaurant, so when you want to increase your expansion or you want to expand your dining area, at the same time you need to also expand your production area to match with the volume of business. Now the other special feature that could be required in a particular catering unit or establishment would be a parking area. What customer facilities are you providing? What employee facilities are you providing to the employees? Do we have this area for the special function? Do we have banquet rooms for the banquet halls? Do we have party rooms to accommodate 1,000 people? So these are all special features we have to keep in mind. Other service when we talk about are service bars, salad bars, display cooking, table side cooking, lobster tanks, pastry carts. These are other facility if you wish to have in your catering establishment that you can have, but that is your plan you have to do, keeping in mind your future business and the volume business you want to cater. This is what I have planned for today's class. We'll see what we have to teach you in the next class, would be a restaurant layout. Looking forward to meet you again. Take care. Bye bye.